welcome to Convict Inc. I'm your host, Robert Rosso. It is Sunday night. I got stuck. June 22nd or whatever it is. I don't even know why I said that. Anyway, so one of the things that happened last week that I didn't mention, and actually it happened on two occasions, was that I participated in the prison talent contest, and it was a total fluke. It started actually last weekend. I was outside and had like an amateur one, meaning it wasn't sanctioned or coordinated by the prison. It was some guys put it together. And there's guys doing poetry, rap, singing, jokes, a bunch of different stuff. And I just kind of goofing around, ended up singing that one. I actually sang Bruce Springsteen, On Fire, Oh, I'm On Fire, blah, blah, blah. So, and I won the contest. And like I said, this was one that was just kind of a joke. And then what happened was I participated and I sang Blowfish, Let Her Cry. That was last weekend and I won. And I didn't mention it until now. Tonight, there was a bocce ball tournament that started yesterday. It was, we played three rounds of elimination with me and my partner, won all three rounds and made it to basically the final or the Super Bowl, and took second place, and it was actually my fault. I blew chunks. I completely blew it on the last hit. We had it in the bag, and I got greedy and screwed it up. Anyway, we won, $20 worth of commissary, I think it comes down to. And likewise in the talent show, it was about the equivalent of that in commissary as well. I got the certificate, so one day on Convict Inc. when I get home, I'll post that. I've never in my life entered any kind of a prison show or anything like that. Like I said, I didn't even mean to. I was just outside. It was a fluke. And I think in the past I did say that when I get out, I'm thinking about doing shorts, doing a little song, singing little songs on shorts. And, yeah, we'll see where that goes. It's just, I don't know. It's different sober. I'll say that. I never did do karaoke, but I guess it came out all right. I mean, I got some commissary and a certificate to show for it. Yeah, but it's pretty cool. And by the way, shout out to my partner, in Burrow out of Arkansas. Wasn't the biggest fan of my judge. My judge also sent him until I pointed out the fact that my judge actually gave him a downward departure on his guidelines and he should have had more time. Anyway, there's three or four guys from the Western District of Arkansas that are here with me. Me and Vincent, we live, we're on the same floor. Actually, he's just recovering from prostate cancer. And we've become pretty decent friends, pretty good friends. He's 58 years old, he's got a boatload of time to do. So, yeah, I'm glad our paths have crossed and he became a really, really good bocce ball partner. Back when I was in the one, back in 2007 to 2010, I used to play bocce ball. Carmine Persico used to play a bit. And actually Bernie sometimes. But yeah, I've been playing almost daily lately. So yeah, it's something to do to kill time. As far as the motion goes, so I mentioned it, and I know I lost a lot of people because I was talking legalese bullshit, and I was kind of actually messing up on that. Here's the bottom line. Tomorrow, I will be filing a brief. It's a motion for a two-point reduction on some guideline changes. Now, I know people out of the Western District of Arkansas listen to this, or did. I think some of them might still probably didn't listen to it like they were because I was on probation. And my PO, I think that was part of his job, was he had to. But maybe they might now for entertainment or whatever, who knows. Anyway, just giving them a heads up. I don't think it's inappropriate to be talking about. It's going to be on PACER, meaning on the legal directory. There's people that...
This call is from a federal prison.
...that have PACER and LexisNexis. They get alerts from those, especially the PACER. PACER's... if you file something in district courts or appeals courts, it can pop up. They can give notices of people's cases. So there's going to be people who are going to see these notices as soon as my case hits the clerk's office, so I don't think it's really inappropriate to say that I'm filing a motion. It's not like putting any pressure on the judge or prosecutor. It's nothing like that. It either is or it isn't. There was an amendment to the guidelines that happened in between me getting my sentence reduced from life up until actually getting my violation handed to me. So I'm surprised that my attorney didn't catch it. The truth is, for you people in the Western District of Arkansas, I think the probation department might actually have to go and do the calculations to see if I qualify. Basically, there was no quantity in drugs in my indictment back in 1997. Therefore, I would fall into the guideline range, specifically under the B1C category. I know people that don't have law degrees will know nothing about what I'm saying, but it's actually given the probation department heads up because I think that they end up doing the judge's work for them, and they'll be on top of it. But I'm filing for an immediate release if I'm granted, because I'm already going to be past my time. If I was granted even a few months off, that would shoot me out the door. And by my indication, by four jailhouse attorneys and one actual lawyer, they all believe that I qualify. And the U.S. attorney, or the assistant U.S. attorney that oversaw my case down there, really didn't care if I got out or went back to prison or not. Anyway, so will there be pushback? Who knows? And if there is, great. If there's not, you know, I have the legal right to file for it, and that's what I've done. And we'll see what happens from there. And if I do get out, maybe I can have dinner with my judge a little earlier, since I'm doing so well. Also, I have talked about my plans for release. I made a contract to myself, and that will not change, period. Period. It's not going to. The only thing I can say is the day I'm going to be released, there are going to be changes in that. Specifically, I'm going to make the Bureau of Prisons pay to fly me to California. It's on them, the dime's on them, and that's what I'm going to do. And as a matter of fact, Southwestern Airlines had run a special for $58 one-way tickets anywhere in the continental United States, and that's what I did. So right now I get out January the 27th. I'm not going to take any classes to get out any earlier than that. That's the date I'm set for. If I'm released immediately, I have it set up to where I can still, the plane fare shouldn't be a problem. I already got my counselor, so they're gonna set me up to fly to LAX. I'm going to go there for a couple days, and one of the things I've always wanted to do when I got out of prison, and I write extensively about this in one of my journals, is that I wanted to go back to the church in which I was raised and walk the aisles and kind of find myself. I've talked about this actually on YouTube when I was out, and was able to do so in a Catholic church in Fort Smith, but it's not the same thing as going back to the church where I grew up. Maybe for nostalgia, whatever it comes down to. But I'm that's one of the things that's important to me. I have the opportunity to do it. Let the Bureau of Prisons pay for it. That's what I'm going to do. I mean, it's already locked. It's already a done deal. So I'm going to go there for at least a couple days. And it's one of the things I planned on for a long time, that and walking through the town in which I was born and raised. I always wanted to go back. I used to dream about that when I was in prison and walk the streets. I used to walk as a kid. I did have hopes of doing that with somebody else, but that's over. So it is what it is. Life goes on. And the first thing I will do when I'm released, as a matter of fact, is I'll go to an AA meeting before I even go to the airport. I've already got that planned out as well. Unless, of course, the judge releases me immediately, and then that's a different case. Anyway, all right, I'm gone. I kind of hate these phone calls because I'm rushing through, and it sucks. Take care. Bye.